I want to say welcome, and this is gonna be, yeah, some kind of a moment. This is has just arrived today from the printers, the physical book Push, Turn, Move, and that's what this masterclass is about. So I'm looking forward to go through some of the concepts. It's a very thick book, as you can see. So we will not get through everything during this class, but I'll do my best to touch upon those areas that I think might interest you the most, and specifically those that are about user-centered design. So I'll just start. I mean, you can, I hope some of you, maybe some of you are beggars, I don't know. And you can look forward to receiving this very soon, in a couple of weeks maybe. We're really excited to send this out now. So let's you're from Germany and all around the US maybe, or I mean, we're sending this book out to 55 countries, and that's for me it's a dream come through, and being able to share it with you here at this masterclass is something I've been looking very much forward to. So just to give you a brief introduction and tell you a little about the book, we went on Kickstarter and was funded within an hour with this project, and huge thanks to backers, if there are any backers here maybe, I don't know. It's now 352 pages printed around the subject, and it's been quite a journey. So we've been working hard for many months, and so now is this it's my opportunity to share this with you, and I'm really looking forward to it. Wow, you're from all over the world. That's just great. So just to tell you a little about the framework of the book, and also for some of this, this is very abstract model of the framework. But it's I built the chapters of the book upon this model. So we start with the user. I mean, this is essential that we are a person or an artist using an instrument, and we have a certain background, certain things we can do, and things we know, situations we are in, and stuff like that. So we have to start there if we have to do a good design. The second part of the model or the framework is the sound around the user. Visualizing sound on instrument can be accomplished in various ways, so we look upon that also. I'll not touch much upon that in this masterclass because we don't have time for that. But around that we have controls, controlling sound, and simply all the different controls we can use to set or generate or route or patch or modify sound. It's from tactile controls to touch and stuff like that. So we look upon knobs and faders, like modulation wheels, buttons and stuff like that. Around that we have a layout. The controls are laid out according to certain design principles. And we'll have a look at those. What are good principles, and how can we use them in the layout of the instruments? This is the layout section, and I'll touch quite upon on some subjects here. It's stuff like Gestalt rules, ergonomic considerations, design traditions, interface factors like visual and tactile feedback, legibility, contrast, grouping, and stuff like that. So when we have laid out our controls according to how we work with sound and according to the user we imagine or work towards, we have a concept, or we work with the concept. So that's the outer form, so to say. It can be anything from, like, you know, drum machines, a synthesizer, a sequencer, etc. So we look at concepts here in the book also, and that's we don't have much time maybe to touch upon it here, but let's see. Around that is the time. I mean, our experience as a maker or user is widely colored by the time we live in, and also the technology that is currently available and already established. So we build upon what is available and what has been available. So we look a bit here in this chapter on some historic elements in the book. So yeah, let's dive in. Also, I just want to talk a little about some instrument categories, some examples, because it's important to also look at what kind of an instrument are we aiming at. What is the commonalities in that category of instruments? So these are just some examples, but just I think we have 11 categories in the book, and these are tangible examples, but they don't have to be. So I mean, the synthesizer is an instrument category, and in this category we need controls to like route and generate sound and adjust maybe live, etc., stuff like that. So that's sound controls. And like in the workstation, maybe it's a bit further, but we have like mixing controls and a big screen and maybe a larger keyboard, whatever. The workstation, of course, can also be something like a digital audio workstation, like Ableton Live, for example. So maybe there's added mixing controls. So just to talk a little about the differences according to what are you aiming at. So, and then there's, for example, the stage piano, where you actually usually minimize the amount of control so that you're in a live situation, have a better overview of the instrument and can react quickly. Also, maybe an even larger keyboard like here, so you have more possibilities when you're performing live. I hope that makes sense. Again, there are much more categories in the book. So also as an introduction, we can look at certain interface types, and this is a very what you can say rough grouping of concepts. We will look at many concepts, but these are four overall types of interfaces. The first one, of course, that we know is the tangible interface. A three-dimensional interface that feature physical control objects like knobs, faders, buttons and the like. One of the advantages of a physical interface is that the user does not have to look at the control being used, but can simply feel their way across, say, a set of synthesizer keys. It's traditionally the most widespread method of interfacing with electronic instruments. This is the Sequential Circuits Pro 1 vintage synthesizer. It's a typical example of a very tangible interface, relying on the user grabbing controls, turning the knobs, pushing the buttons, pressing keys. So that's one overall or generic type. Then we have the graphical and text-based interface, which is found in software, apps, on screens, in virtual reality applications. And it consists of these visual representations of parameters and objects. Though the interaction with the graphical interface is done by using input devices like a mouse, computer, keyboard, maybe multi-touch or tangible controls, it's still termed graphical because it only exists as a visual representation. We know this from DAWs and like Logic Pro here. And we can also, we'll dive a bit into that, about the visual representations that sometimes resemble real life objects, but also may be very abstract in their graphical presentation. Then we have touch-based interfaces, which is based on the user touching a flat surface. And this can be more or less sensitive to factors such as the number of touch points, like fingers, the amount of pressure or the movements performed on the surface. And these are usually dependent on touch strips, capacitive touch sensing in surfaces, or multi-touch screens, and like here also the Rolly blocks. This detects multiple touch nuances, and I think it was today or yesterday maybe, they announced a new version. So, and the last one is the gestural and sensor-based interface type. So gestural interfaces, they process elements of a physical performance in order to translate the motion into musical or control data. And for this, an array of sensor types exists, either as wearables on the performer's, you know, body or hands, or via external tracking such as cameras, infrared sensors, or components that register the electrical current of the human body, for example. So this is the theremin in a modern interpretation, the MOOC's theremini, with the two antennas here, with changes in pitch and volume. So this is gestural and sensor based, and in the book we also look into gloves, for example, the Vimu gloves, and a lot of other stuff. So this is just to say, this is the general interface types, and again, they have certain commonalities, they have certain differences, they have certain aspects of them that we have to consider when designing an interface, whether it's tangible, graphical, touched, or gestural or sensor based.